a walk in the woods at Saint-Germain-en-Laye, just outside Paris. But Jérôme isn't looking for wildlife. He's the president of an association that fights AIDS. And this forest is one of the capital's most popular illicit meeting places for men. Every day, an average of 500 men have sex in these woods. The vast majority are straight, married, and have children. This invisible population runs a much higher risk of catching HIV than those who are openly gay.
Because they hide their sexual relations, they're not going to talk about it with their doctor. They won't necessarily go to the ER to get post-exposure treatment. They're not going to spontaneously call the AIDS hotline. We're often the only health service they're willing to talk to about having had sexual relations with men.
Jean-Claude is a regular here. He has taken on the role of a go-between for the association. Divorced and with children, he's been living with HIV for a quarter of a century. He's open about it.
I'll tell all the young guys, yeah. Well, all right, not everyone. But anyone who approaches me about it, yes. I don't get involved with people who don't use protection anymore. Categorically not.
The association hands out condoms and advice on a daily basis. In the last year alone, they have screened 1,500 people in these woods for HIV. 3% of those tested here are HIV positive, much higher than those who make it to the formal labs in the city.
Le test a fonctionné avec un point de contrôle qui révèle aussi un résultat négatif.
It's always reassuring. This test is something to give you a first bit of information. If you have any doubts after that, well, then you go to the lab.
For this anonymous population, catching early signs of the HIV virus may be the saving grace to keeping AIDS at bay.